Hello viewers, today we will be studying about refraction through spherical surface. Now refraction means when a ray of light passes from one medium to another medium of different optical density, it shows bending. Bending can be towards the normal if the ray is passing from rarer to denser medium, and it is away the normal when it is going from denser to rarer medium. Now refraction can also be shown in water, sound, or any other waves. The refraction of light actually makes it possible for us to have lenses, magnifying glasses, prisms, and rainbows. Even our eyes depend upon this bending of light. Without refraction, we wouldn't be able to focus light onto our retina. See children, whenever any topic is being taught to you, it should always be behind your mind that why I'm studying this topic. So these are some uses of refraction. Everywhere we are using, our eyes are made up of convex lens. So refraction occurs there also. In camera also, we are using lenses which causes refraction. Our spectacles, many uses are there. Now, refraction through plane surface. We already know about this. If this is the interface, this is medium one, which is your rarer medium. This is medium two, which is your denser medium. This is the normal drawn over here. If a ray of light is incident at the point of incidence, because it is going from rarer to denser, so it will go towards the normal. This will be angle I and this will be angle R. If the reverse happens, that is this is denser, this is rarer, ray of light is going from denser to rarer medium, then the bending will be away the normal. So this will be your angle R, and this is your angle I. Now the two conditions for refraction. First condition is that the two mediums should have different optical density. And the second condition that the incident ray should fall obliquely. It should not fall normally. There are two laws of refraction. First, the incident ray, the refracted ray and the normal all should lie in the same plane. And the second one is the ratio of sine of angle of incidence upon sine of angle of refraction is always a constant, which is known as refractive index. Now coming to our today's topic, that is refraction through spherical surface. How this spherical surface is created? If this is a glass sphere, this is the center. So this is called the center of curvature. This is the radius of curvature. If I cut the sphere in this form, then I'm getting a spherical surface over here. This is the radius of curvature. This is your C. And any line drawn from this surface to this center of curvature will be normal to it. Yes, it will be normal to it. Now, taking the spherical surface, this is the spherical surface, and this is your principal axis. This is my center of curvature. Now, if I put the point object here, this side, medium one, this is medium two. And I want to see from the medium one, then I can see it clearly. But what if I go to the other side of the spherical surface? Then how I will be able to see? Only through refraction. So how the image is formed, let us see that. First ray goes across the principal axis towards the center of curvature and simply passes away. Second ray of light will... First, let me draw this normal. Second ray of light will go here at the point of incidence over here. Let us name this as P. and then it will go towards the normal, forming the image this eye. See, you can see two rays are meeting at this point, one this refracted ray and one this line, this ray, sorry. So though both are meeting at eye, so eye is the image formed over here. Now let us name this as angle alpha, this as angle beta, and this one as angle gamma. Alpha, beta, gamma, all these are unknown to us. So now, Snell's law, we have read about Snell's law. What does Snell's law say? Angle, this is angle of incidence, this is angle of refraction. This is medium one, this is medium two. So Snell's law says N1 sine I is equal to N2 sine R. Now this angle I and angle R are small. So instead of sine I, we can write I, and instead of sine R, we can write R. So it comes out to be N1 I equals to N2 R. Fine. Now from this triangle, let us see this figure, and from triangle POC, see this triangle POC, I is the exterior angle. So this exterior angle is the sum of the interior angles alpha plus beta. Let us name this equation number one. Now in triangle, in other triangle, we see triangle PCI, beta is equal to R plus gamma. That means R is equal to beta minus gamma. Let us put this equation number two. Now we have to find this alpha, beta and gamma. We are not knowing this. And we are having this equation that N1I is equal to N2 R. So we can put the values of I and R from equation one and two. So what do we get here? N1 alpha plus beta is equal to N2 beta minus gamma. N1 alpha plus N1 beta equals to N2 beta minus N2 gamma. So this comes out to be N1 alpha plus N2 gamma equals to N2 minus N1 beta. Now for finding the value of alpha, gamma, beta, let us see the diagram. In this diagram, we have to draw a normal. We are doing one construction, we are dropping one normal. Let this be Q. Now you can see in this figure, because this distance is very, very small, so we can take OQ as U, then QC as R, and QI as V. Fine. Now in triangle POQ, you can see this, what will be tan alpha? Tan alpha will be PQ upon OQ. Then in triangle PQC, tan beta will be how much? PQ upon QC. And in triangle PQI, what will be your tan gamma? PQ upon QI. So now let us write as this. Alpha, tan alpha will be equal to PQ upon OQ. Tan beta will be PQ upon, see, again I'm going to the diagram over here for your concept to be clear. Beta here, this will be equal to QC. And tan gamma will be equal to PQ upon QI. Now, if we put these value over here, you can see PQ upon OQ becomes PQ upon minus U, because OQ is, I'm writing it again over here, OQ is minus U. QC is plus R and QI is plus V. Now, why I'm written here minus and plus? Using the sign convention, come to the diagram. See, if the incident ray is going in this manner towards right, then all the measurements taken from the pole over here, these will be all positive, and against the incident ray, it will be negative. So U will be negative and R and V will be positive. So now coming to the back to this equation, tan alpha will be equal to PQ upon minus U, tan beta will be equal to PQ upon R, and tan gamma will be equal to PQ upon V. Now again, these angles are small, so it can be written as alpha, this beta and this gamma. Now we were having this equation over here, N1I is equal to N2R. On putting the values, finally we got this equation. Let this be equation number 3. That is N1 alpha plus, you can see here, don't be confused, N1 alpha plus N2 gamma. N2 gamma is equal to N2 minus N1 beta. Minus N1 beta. And now we will put the values. N1 PQ upon minus U plus N2 gamma means PQ upon V is equal to N2 minus N1 beta, that is PQ upon R. PQ, 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 all will cancel here. So we are getting here minus N1U plus N2V is equal to N2 minus N1R. So this is the formula for spherical refraction through the spherical surface. This is only when the ray goes from rarer to denser medium. If it goes from denser to rarer medium, then what will be the formula? Just you change this minus N2U plus N1V is equal to N1 minus N2R. This is from denser to rarer medium. Now children, if we do a numerical, then our concepts become more clear. So let us solve a numerical over here. If U is given 100 centimeter, this will be minus, just now I told you according to sign convention, and N1 is air, so it will be 1, N2 is given 1.5, and R is given plus 20 centimeter. You have to find the image distance V, and it is going from rarer to denser medium. The rays are going from rarer to denser. So the formula just now we have evaluated. This is the formula is equal to N2 minus N1 upon R. So on putting these values, see what we'll get. Minus 1 upon minus 100 plus 1.5 upon V is equal to 1.5 minus 1 upon 20. This comes out to be 0.5 upon 20. Or it can also be written as 5 upon 200. So 1.5 upon V will be equal to 5 upon 200. This becomes plus, so minus 1 upon 100. Taking the LCM, 200 and this comes out to be 5 minus 2, that is 3 upon 200. Therefore, V will be equal to 1.5 into 200 upon 3. So on solving, we get this 0.5 into 200. This comes out to be plus 100 centimeters. So this is the answer. You will be solving more numericals based on this formula. So I hope, children, now your concept is clear. Keep on solving more and more numericals. We will be back with the second video. Thank you, all of you. Thank you.